Hello, and welcome to our presentation on practices for engineering trustworthy machine learning applications. My name is Alex Serban, and I'm a researcher at Radboud University in the Netherlands and at a Software Improvement Group, a company based in Amsterdam. This research was developed together with Koen, Holger, and Joost, which are researchers at Leiden University. This project is part of a larger effort we make to collect, validate, and share software engineering best practices for machine learning. In this project, we focus in particular on practices for trustworthy machine learning. Trustworthy machine learning is becoming a very important issue because it impacts users of machine learning services and the society. In this research, we focused in particular on operational practices for trustworthy machine learning systems that can become part of the software development cycles. Already, several guidelines have been proposed for trustworthy machine learning, such as those advanced by the high-level expert group in artificial intelligence set up by the European Commission. However, when studying these guidelines, we observed that most of them are not directly operational and cannot be applied by practitioners in their day-to-day life. Therefore, we strive to discover operational practices that can be directly adopted by these. The process that we follow in our project is to start by first reviewing the literature, and then creating a catalog of practices, distilling the information from the literature, and then run a survey in which we measure the practice adoption and the effects. We already did this for other practices in the software development lifecycle for machine learning, and now, given that our catalog was missing practices in the area of trustworthy machine learning, we decided to add them and restart the process. We also plan to expand the catalog with other practices following the same process. In order to discover the practices, we performed a multivocal literature review, including both academic and grade literature. For the queries, we used synonyms or disambiguations of trustworthy machine learning, such as bias, robustness, or interpretable. To distill the results, we used thematic analysis, which allowed us to identify and merge common themes between the documents resulting. In total, we compiled 14 new practices for trustworthy machine learning, and used the practices to complement an already existing catalog of ML engineering practices and a reading list. Both the catalog and the reading list can be found by accessing the links on the right. The catalog was built in the previous stages of the study, as mentioned earlier. In order to classify the results, we used the requirements for trustworthy AI from the high-level expert group set up by the European Commission. These requirements define trustworthy machine learning or AI as ethical, lawful, and robust. And the guidelines for these three standing pillars are both technical and non-technical. For technical solutions, there are seven key requirements, ranging from human agency and oversight to privacy or data governance or accountability. Here, we showcase the resulting practices and their connection to the key requirements from the high-level expert group on artificial intelligence. We can see that the practices are very broad and are ranging from testing for social bias in training data or preventing discriminatory data attributes from being used as model features, up to assuring application security, providing audit trails, performing risk assessments, informing users on ML usage, or having the application audited. As we can see on the mapping to the seven key requirements from the EU, one of the requirements was not addressed by any practice in the literature, and this is ensuring that ML applications ensure societal and environmental well-being. As we can see, transparency is addressed by multiple practices, while privacy and data governance is addressed only by one practice. Overall, we were happy to discover that most requirements from the EU High-Level Special Group on AI are addressed by operational practices in literature, but one, and we are working towards complementing and finding solutions for this one. In order to measure the practice adoption, we ran an online survey. The survey had four standard answers on the Likert scale, designed to measure the adoption, starting from not at all, partially, mostly, and completely. For the practices that did not fit this range of results, we added three other results, such as we do not process data related to people, or using interpretable models is not possible for the use case. In total, we received 105 answers, but after filtering, only 42 of them were complete. For filtering, we used stringent requirements such that all the practices were complete. The results are displayed on the picture on the right. As we can see, overall, the adoption of practices for trustworthy machine learning is very low. This can be interpreted as counting the percentage of not at all or partial adoption of these practices. As we can see, the colors related to these practices are more prevalent. This means that the practices had low adoption. In particular, we observed that the practices related to application security had very low adoption, such as this one. This result is a cause of concern given the importance of security to software and the amount of literature that exists on security of machine learning. However, when looking in the literature, we observe that most of these results are not operational. For example, the defenses against adversarial examples, which are a known threat to security, have been breached. On the other side of the spectrum, we observe that some practices related to explaining results to users or establishing channels to raise concerns have higher adoption. We hypothesize that this higher adoption is given by the more mature legislation or constraints in this area, and we plan to investigate this in the future by running interviews. As previously mentioned, the practices are available online in a catalog. The practices consist of detailed descriptions and concise statements of intent, motivation, applicability, related practices and references. For this, we seek inspiration from design patterns. In the catalog, you can easily see which practices address which requirements from the EU by clicking the label. As we gather more data, we also plan to assess the difficulty of adopting each of the practices. A similar result was obtained with the other practices that were developed in earlier stages of the project. If you'd like to contribute, I would like to invite you to take the survey that is available on our website. I would like to also invite you to see the reading list and mention that the catalog and the reading list are open source and contributions are welcome. In order to get more information about the methodology used to construct this catalog, I would like to invite you to read the papers or to follow our project at seml.github.io. Thank you for your attention, and I would be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, everyone. We have Alex here with me, and let's see what the audience has as questions. Or one more comment comes from Ivica. In different communities, trustworthy is defined differently. Have you noticed that? This different understanding will probably require a mutual understanding.
Yes, so in general, this work especially is based on the EU recommendations. So in the context of EU, what we're doing now is we're analyzing how people define trustworthiness or, for example, explainability in different contexts, and then try to abstract some common understanding from it. So we've observed this and we're working on it.
Thank you. Another question from Justus. Do you think the better tool support at AutoML could ease the adoption of some of those practices for trustworthiness? Or is it more an experience skill problem?
I think it's both. But once we can abstract past experience and skills, we can also develop these AutoML tools. In general, what we found is that there is good support for tools that already do testing for bias or testing for different attributes of trustworthiness, but their results need also experience and skills to interpret. So I think it will remain, for the most part, a balance between the two.
Thank you. One question from Lionel. The problem is the security in machine learning is mostly tackled with adversarial examples, right? And most of the techniques generate unrealistic examples, thereby wasting engineers' time.
So we tend to agree with this, but there's actually the security of ML is also based, for example, on poisoning attacks or poisoning the data sets before training the model. So you can think of users uploading on, I don't know, on Facebook different pictures such that their training data is poisoned. So adversarial examples is a big topic, but there are others which are a bit more important. Actually, in adversarial examples, I agree that the examples are unrealistic. But if we think also a bit of, in general, we have a malware sample and an automatic malware detector. If we flip a bit in the malware sample, that's also considered an adversarial example. So then that's realistic.
Thank you. Well, we don't have any more questions. We will soon move to the discussion room. Maybe one last question, and we can take it also there, is which one of these practices do you think is the most difficult to be adopted?
From what people did, is actually the security, and I still consider that the security one because it's more volatile and it's harder to define security in the context of machine learning. So I think that's the